Hello friends, the topic for today is master synchronous serial port SPI mode, that is serial peripheral interface mode, to transfer data serially one bit at a time. The microcontroller must convert its parallel word into a stream of serial bits. This is called as parallel to serial conversion. Similarly, to receive data serially, the microcontroller must receive one bit at a time and convert stream of serial bits into a parallel word. This is called serial to parallel conversion. Many protocols have been developed that are suitable for a given application and accepted as standards. Some of the standards are EIA 232 or RS 232, primarily used for PCs. And second standard is Serial Peripheral Interface, SPI, synchronous serial interfacing protocol for communication between microcontroller and peripheral devices. And the third standard is Inter-Integrated Circuit, that is I2C, a protocol developed by Philips for synchronous serial communication between microcontroller and peripheral devices. Master Synchronous Serial Port, MSSP, module implements serial communication in SPI and I2C modes. In today's video, you will learn the SPI mode of MSSP in PIC 18 microcontroller. Let us start. Welcome to our channel Engineering and Technology for You. If you are not subscribed, kindly subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that you can get updates about future videos. The topic for today is PIC 18 Master Synchronous Serial Port, that is SPI mode. Let us start with the serial peripheral interface basic concepts. The basic concepts of SPI are, first is 4-wire interface. The 4-wire interface includes 4 signals, clock, data in, data out, and slave select or chip select. Then the second concept is synchronous protocol. The clock signal is provided and controlled by the master device, and the data are sent with the clock pulses. That is, the data are synchronous with the clock. Therefore, the clock can vary without disturbing the data flow. That is the synchronous protocol concept. Then the next concept is master slave protocol. The master device controls the clock line, that is SCK, and can communicate with multiple slave devices. However, there is only one master in the SPI protocol, so no data will be transferred unless the clock is manipulated. And all slaves are controlled by the clock, which is manipulated by the master device. That's why we call it as the master slave protocol. Then let us see the next concept, data exchange protocol. Each device, master or slave, has two data lines, one for input and one for output. Data are always exchanged between the devices. As data are being transmitted with MSB first, new data are being received. A device cannot only transmit or receive data. For example, when a master transmits a data byte, it must read the incoming data byte from the slave before transmitting the next data byte. Even if the received data may have any meaning or use for the particular application, it has to receive the data. So that's why this is a data exchange protocol. Then the next concept is master selects a slave. A slave device is selected by a signal from the master, and the signal is generally known as
slave select or SS bar, or chip select CS bar. Then the last concept is data exchange and clock. Data typically change during the rising or falling edge of the clock, and the sampling and the data change takes place on opposite edge of the clock. So that is the concept data exchange and clock. Then let us see the, here you can see the master and the slave. Master is generally the microcontroller. It has a clock signal which is SCK, serial clock, generates the clock, and that's why it is the master. And the slave receives the clock from the master. Then we have two lines, MOSI and MISO. MOSI means master out, slave in. So this is the signal which is out from the master and received by the slave. And the MISO, master in, slave out. So this is the output signal from the slave and received by the, and the last signal is the slave select, SS. So here, this is the slave select signal. It tells the slave that it should wake up and receive or send data, and also used when multiple slaves are present to select the one you would like to talk to. The SS line is normally high, as you can see here, and it is active low. So when it goes low, during whenever it is low, the data transfer rate. So you can see the waveforms here. The when data is sent from the master, it will be sent on this MOSI line. You can see here, this is the MSB 0101 0011, that is 53 hexadecimal or ASCII. And whenever the slave sends the data, it will be sent on the MISO line. You can see here, this is 0100 0110, that is 46 hexadecimal or ASCII. So this is how the data will be sent by the slave to the master. So the data exchange will take place. Then let us go to the next part, that is master SSP module overview. Master synchronous serial port is a serial interface useful for communicating with other peripherals or microcontroller devices. So these peripherals may be serial EEPROMs, shift registers, display drivers, A2D converters, etc. So there are two modes in which the MSSP module operates: serial peripheral interface SPI and inter integrated circuit I2C or I2C. And again, it works in the full master mode or the slave mode. Then I2C interface supports master mode, multi-master mode and slave mode in the hardware. Then let us go to the MSSP module SPI mode. The SPI mode allows 8 bits of data to be synchronously transmitted and received simultaneously. All 4 modes of SPI are supported. These 4 modes are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, that is depending on the falling and rising edge of the clock. So 3 pins are used: serial data out SDO, serial data in SDI, and serial clock SCK. So they are similar to the MISO and other pin. Then another 4th pin is the slave select, that is SS, or the chip select. And these RA5, RB1, RB0, RC7. These are the multiplex signals on this pin. Then this is the MSSP block diagram. You can see here the four pins, the SCK, then SS, SDO and SDI. So this clock pin, it will get the input from the clock. So this is the input, and there is a prescaler 4, 16, 64. These three prescalers are used. And then it has got the edge select blocks. There is one more, this is from the timer to output. Then these are the shift registers and the SSP buffer. So that shift register will shift the bits, and the SSP buffer will collect the bits, and then it will be out of the internal and it will be transmitted. Then let us go to the registers of SPIO. The MSSP module has four registers: the control register, SSP con 1, then status register, SSP stat, then the receive transmit buffer register, that is the SSP buff, and the shift register, SSP SR, which is not directly accessible by the program. Then the SSP con 1 and SSP stats, they are the control and status registers. The SSP con register is readable and writable. Whereas the SSP stat, the lower 6 bits are read only, and only the 2 upper bits are read write. Then this is the shift register, and this is the buffer. These two combinedly, they create the double buffered receiver and receives a complete byte. It is transferred to the buffer, and the serial synchronous serial port interrupt flag is set. Then during transmission, it is not double buffered. A write to this will write to both SSP buffer and SSP shift register. Then this is the status register. Here we have the bit 7, that is the sample bit. In master mode, if it is 1, then input data are sampled at the end of the data output time. And if it is 0, input data are sampled at the middle of the data output time. Then in slave mode, it must be cleared. So the slave mode, it will be sampled at the middle of the data output. Then bit 6 is CKE, that is the clock select bit. If it is 1, transmit occurs on the transition from active to idle state. And 0, transmit occurs from transition from idle to active clock state. That is rising and falling edge. Then bit 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. These are the bits mode used in I2C mode only. We will not discuss them. And bit 0 is buffer full. If it is 1, receive complete. So the SSP buffer is full. And if it is 0, receive not complete, SSP buffer is empty. And let us go to the control register, SSP con 1. So here again, bit 7 is write collision detect bit. So it is for the transmit mode. If it is written, say this buffer register is written while it is still transmitting the previous word, that means there is a collision, and so this bit will be set. It must be clear in the software. And if it is 0, there is no collision. And bit 6 is for the receive overflow indicator. It is for the slave mode. So when a new byte is received while the buffer register is still holding the previous data, in that case the anytime the shift register is lost. So overflow can only occur in the slow mode. So again, it has to be cleared in the slow mode. And when it is zero, there is no overflow. Then bit 5, it is for the master synchronous serial port enable. If it is 1, it will enable the and configure the SCK, SDO, SDI and SS bar. This serial port pins. And if it is 0, it will disable the pins. Then bit 4 is SCKP, that is the clock priority select bit. If it is 1, idle state for the clock is high level. If it is 0, idle state is low. Then bit 3 to 0, these are for the serial port mode select bits. So if you take 0000, it is for the master mode, clock is prescalar is 4. Then next the prescalar is 60, next the prescalar is 64. And in this case, it is using the timer 2 output divided by 2 will be the clock. And if it is 01, then 00 or 0101, it is for the slow mode. So in this case, the SS pin is control is enabled, whereas in this case, the SS pin control is. Then let us see the connection between the microcontrollers for the master slave connection. So here, this is the SPI master, so 00XX, that is the point. And this is the slave, that is 010, and then this is the clock signal, that is the serial clock, which is connected to the slave. And here we have the SDO for the slave is given as the input for the master, and then SD. 0 of master is given as SDN. So on the clock, the data will come out, the MSB first will come out and it will be transferred on this line SD0. So SDI will receive it and it will be again given to the shift register, and then from there it will go to the serial. So in this way the protocol will. So you can see here the details. The master controller initiates the data transfer by sending the clock signal, serial clock signal. The data is shifted out of the both shift registers on the program clock edge and flashed on the output opposite edge of the clock. Both processors should be programmed to the same clock polarity, that is the CKP bit. Then both controllers would send and receive the data at the same time. So this is a data exchange protocol and synchronous protocol. So it will transmit and receive at the. So whether the data is meaningful or dummy data depends on the application. So here there's three scenarios are possible. Let us understand that. Master sends data, slave sends dummy data. So this is the transmission mode. Then master sends data, slave sends data. So this is transmission as well as reception. And the last, master sends dummy data and slave sends data. So that means the master is receiving the data. So this is the reception mode. So this is how the SPI master slave connection. So with this, we come to the end of this video. If you have any questions, you can contact me on Facebook, Twitter, Gmail or Instagram. And if you like the video, press the like button, share with your friends and subscribe to our channel Engineering and Technology for you. And if you want to get notifications, press the bell icon. And thanks for watching. Have a nice day.
I have you now.